have looked through. The first one is we need to start search very early. Okay, why? Because if you're looking to do it outside of the organization, then in that case, have not any candidates. So they start the procedure of summer internship or internship, okay, at least 3 to 6 months before. So let's say you will go for your intern in January. So they will start looking for the interns, like the screening procedure will start right from July, July, August. That will be the most critical. But after you will not go in. Will make a search a little bit difficult. So that you have to keep in mind that you search very, very quickly. Then where do I apply? That has to be very clear. Okay. Many like questions, the students, they used to come and they say that we have joined the intern. We are not happy. So why you are not happy? Because you have not identified your broad career interest, where you want to go, which technology you are interested in. So you have to be more focused in that particular, I can say, upskilling yourself where you find the interest. And based on that interest for the internships accordingly. Now, it may so happen that someone is not so, I mean to say, it's quite balanced enough and he's flexible. So in that case, that is not an issue. But it may so happen that some maybe may find very much interesting in, let's say, Android, okay, application. Someone may not feel good to work in web databases kind of project. So it is purely your choice where your interest lies about, lies. Okay, completely. So based on your interest only, you have to take the decisions because then only you will be able to make a mark, okay? Then another one is network. That means you have to build a network. So whenever you are trying to find internships, you need to, whom you need to speak. You need to speak to the, you can say family, if you have someone working in industry or maybe your seniors, okay, who have already been through the process, so that is very important. Faculty, okay, so you should speak to faculty at least. If suppose someone is not like involved in the internship and placement activity, but they'll have an idea about what is the trend in the market because they are from that domain. So you should speak then some advisors if you have, or the placement cell of your college, that what kind of internship and which area you want to do. Okay, then alumni, contacting the pass out alumni, that will be very helpful because alumni are already in very significant position. So contacting the pass out, and let's say 3 to 5 to 6 years, they're already established. So somewhere down the line, they will help you, maybe in their company or maybe they will refer, they'll have a huge network by that time. So that way you have to build. Okay, you have to come out of your shell and then you have to do it. Do it for whom? For yourself. Now, it may so happen that you may complain that we are not getting updates. Like, how will we know where the internship is coming out? Okay, how do we apply? So we did not worry because nowadays many online resources are there, okay, where you can apply the internships. They post. Internships may be giving a huge amount of stipend, isn't it? So in that case, you will come to know. So which are these platforms? Internshala, it's a very good source. MyWays is a new one. The more you hope to look for internship abroad. So what you need to do, you just depending on your interest. Okay, so it's an open document that all of you create, and then you will keep on getting regular updates, and you never know that you will get a very, very good internship. Because for us here, let's say we want to do, let's say, what wants to do. get internships there outside directly, or contacting those companies also may not work in the proper platform, that we should make use of the platform. Okay. Another thing which you can do is, I have really found a lot of employers. Okay. So if suppose you are in, let's say you want to do internship in Guwahati, then in that case, it's very simple. You can go to the office, you can meet them, you can speak, okay? And they will also, kind of brief introduction they'll be taking, where you have to speak about your skills, some basic questions will be, they will be asking. So that's you, that is being expected. Now, if suppose if the employers is out of state, then how do we approach? So what you can do is, you can connect with them through LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a very, very powerful platform. I've already spoken that you should have an account here, because it gives you the scope of networking. Secondly, for connecting with people who are basically directly involved in inducting the interns, or the people who are involved in conducting placements, or maybe the HR and talent acquisition team. So you, what you can do is, you can connect to them. You can send a request connection, and if they accept, then politely you can put it up like you are looking for this. Or if suppose you have a huge bunch of connection of various talent acquisition team, so in their company, every time the interns prospect always comes up. So whenever there is an update from their side, so you can know and you can apply according. But how do you approach to them also? There is a particular, okay, I mean to say, it's not, it should not be very much informal. It should be very much limited to your skills, what you want to do, and proper salutation should be given so that it looks very much decent. Okay, so maybe we will work on this, how to approach them, what are the things we need to draft properly, isn't it? That is important. Then when you are starting out as a new graduate, like new graduate here, it can be a BTech, it can be MSc Computer Science, it can be a BCA, it can be MCA as well, okay? So the main motive here is that to gain experience, okay? So in the initial phase, your internship will carry a huge definition in your, as well as in your upskilling. So you have to make use the most of it, okay? So internships can actually be the medium between an unsatisfying career and a potentially new and exciting venture. Okay, so internship is actually a bridge. Whenever you will go for an interview also, let's say a fresher goes for an interview. So a fresher doesn't have much, he will have no work experience in terms of, full-time employee. But what he will show then in that case? So in that particular time, this is the internship work that you will be going to be showing it to them. So that's why an internship has to be taken very seriously, and the work has to be very, very good. Okay, so that will not only be helpful now, but also in your future perspective. Okay, then this is very, very important. Whenever suppose you are applying an email, okay, you are sending your CV, and CV should be one page CV. So I'll give you a format also, how to frame. Okay, a particular template will be there. So one page CV should always be ready with you. And whenever you are upskilling yourself, you are learning new skills, you have to update that immediately in your CV, because your CV is actually your reflection. So that's why the CV has to be very, very much updated. Then second thing, what you have to know is how to draft an email. Okay, because it's not that request has come and then you just send the CV without any proper salutation, okay, without any kind of a greeting. It's not done, okay? So in professional environment, you have to keep note of all this, how you approach, okay, how you present, okay? That is very, very important, okay? By maintaining proper writing etiquette, that is very, very important, okay? So this is how you have to approach, okay? So first is, you have to start the search immediately when this phase is over. So you have to do the work. Then you have to identify from now on which area you want to work, okay? Like which excites you. So according to that, you have to plan. Networking, so you have to get in contact with your family members, so working in industry, or maybe seniors, friends, or maybe faculty members who think, who you can relate with and who can clear your queries, okay? Then some advisors, so then placement cells. So all these carries a very, very important role. We have said that MLA will need to be, so you have to make parts. You have to go and approach every time whenever you are in doubt. Then if you want to apply for internships, so we don't worry anymore because we have various platforms like Internshala, MyWays, internships.com. So what we need to do is we just need to create an account. Okay, and it's completely free. So we will keep on getting the updates, okay, frequently whenever there is something. Then if suppose we want to go directly, if suppose we want to apply internship in our city, okay, then what do? We need not worry. We can drop in into the office, maybe meet the HR or maybe the technical team will ask us to give a brief description about ourselves, about what skills we have. So we have to do it that way. And if suppose we want to connect outside, maybe in, let's say, bigger cities where accessibility directly going is not feasible, then also we need not worry because we can link through them, maybe through LinkedIn. It's just one kind of method I have said, okay, to link with the HR or the talent acquisition team, okay? And from a new graduate perspective, so you have to make sure that the internship is very, very good. You learn a lot because that will actually help you in your future career perspective. So these are very, very important. And whenever you are approaching someone, so you have to make sure that you're writing etiquette, how you draft your email, prepare your CV. CV also should be one page, which basically only will tell you about you in a very brief way, but to the point. So that has to be very, very proper. Okay. So this is the way you have to work on getting the internship. I think it's very clear what you need to do. Okay, this is the things to do for every student. Now, as per the employability factor, the trend which is there and which will be going for, let's say, 10 to 15 years more, or maybe even broader, some of the areas that you can look for internship, which will help you in getting good jobs. Okay, so in order to get the internship, first of all, you have to get the skills. So how will you get these skills? You can learn, right, through various resources. So first, according to, you can say, the employment point of view, which are the most demanding sectors of IT? Okay, so first is the data scientist. Okay, so who can be a data scientist? Anyone, okay, but they just need to have these kind of skills. So first is ability to work with complex formulas. Okay, so I have given out of 100, like it is also broken down. Okay, so you should be able to work with various mathematical formulas, understanding of the consumer, what the consumer basically wants. You need to have little bit of, let's say, acumen of business. Let's say, for example, one company basically hires you as a data scientist. So you need to plan it out, everything for them, how this product is going to make an impact, okay? So how you are going to analyze the entire thing, okay? So that basically you have to look for. So these are the skills that you need to have. Skilled at one of the programming languages, maybe Python is the most preferred nowadays. So this you can really think about having this, okay? Now, what is the average salary if you suppose master this? So the average salary is in India, it's 9,50,000 per year. And in different cities, it shows variance. So Mumbai has record, like this is the, you can say, the average salary. So 11 lakh for a fresher, Bangalore maybe 10 lakh, Pune maybe 8 lakh. Okay, so if you want to go in this direction, then first you have to learn. So learning, you need not worry. There's so many courses online, NPTEL, Coursera, Udemy, isn't it? So Swayam, so you can get yourself registered and you can learn. Okay, so maybe if suppose, let's say, people who are applying also for internship in these kind of areas will be very, very less. So hence you'll have more prospects. Okay, so that's why you can think about it. Then machine learning expert. So we already know that machine learning is nothing but a application of AI where a particular system learns, and then it does not need any human, you can say, interruption. Okay, it learns and improves its journey on its own without being explicitly being programmed. Okay, so what are the skills that we need? So first of all, you need Python in programming, little bit of statistical knowledge. I think most of you are from science background, so that should not be a problem. Strong written and oral communication. Okay, so written and oral communication should be very good, like the grasping thing, what it is, what we are trying to do. Okay, translated in as the ability to prepare presentations, give periodic progress reports, and you need to visualize how the systems, the data in the systems will be interacting with one another. So these things you will be learning only when you will be doing Python followed by machine learning course. So this covered. Okay, so that's why I would recommend most, this is little bit, I mean to say on the higher side, but most of you try to learn Python and machine learning, okay, from Udemy or maybe Coursera. Most of you are already learning, I suppose. BCS have already started, isn't it? If I'm not mistaken. So MC and MSc also, if you want good internship and good job also. So in that aspect, you should be able to tap on this. Okay, so what is the starting salary which will range? It will be from 7 lakhs to 15 lakhs per annum. So in 1 year, it'll be 7 lakhs to 15 lakhs. That will be the range. Okay, so this is very, very good, very demanding at present. So I think you should go for it. Okay, then next is blockchain developer. So it's a revolution which basically defines interconnection between various fields like currency, transactions, internet connectivity, network, and data security. Okay, so what are the skills you need? Basically, good knowledge of data structure, cryptography, that is network security, and web development. Okay, so in India, basically, the professionals, they basically earn from 7 to 12 lakhs per annum. This is also very much demanding in internships, because last time also, one of the company came for BCA, and they were looking for blockchain developer, but we could not supply them. And they were willing to pay stipend also, 20,000, but we could not supply them because we did not have blockchain developers at that point, or no one was having the skill. So this is also very, very good and very upcoming. So you can plan it accordingly. Okay. So then next we have, these are the areas that you should be doing something in your lockdown team. Okay, I would recommend that at least one, you take it in hand and finish it off. Okay. The next is digital marketing. Digital marketing is an interdisciplinary area. So these days, people who are from BTech, people who are from management, people from humanities also, they have come in. So it's a very open area. Okay, so digital marketing, from the name itself, basically you are marketing the brands, okay, or product, okay, but using digital medium. Because everything is digital, the reach is so high, okay, but how you are going to attract the potential consumers, what are the strategies you are going to make, how you are going to convince the people through maybe the visibility of a mobile app, challenging as well as rewarding also for the company. So this is also very, very good. So maybe this you can learn, others are also there, this also you can learn whenever you have your free time, maybe you can think about it. And if you are really wanting to go this into a profession, let's say you don't like programming much, isn't it? So there may be people, but you are very good with, you can say, words, with English keywords. Okay, you know how to play with the English words. Then in that case, you can try it out this also. Okay, so a digital marketing executive at the entry level will have something about 3.5 to 4 lakhs per annum, but it may be more also, depending upon how good you are, the organization, the company, and also the location. Okay, where is it? So depending upon that, so this also for those people who are not so very friendly with programming or maybe with technology, then they, you can go here also. Okay, then the other one, which is also very, very upcoming, not upcoming, there has been there, I would say, the web development has been there, but mobile application development is picking up very, very rapidly. Okay, so this is also a very important, I mean to say, aspect that one should look for. If you want to go for Android development, mobile app development, then you should look for these technologies. It's not that web development has worn out, but okay, it has switched to more cutthroat framework. Okay, so accordingly, you can look for, and what will be the packages then for these, okay? So package will be around 3 lakhs in tier 2 and tier 3 cities, okay, for mobile app, or maybe if someone knows Laravel or CodeIgniter. Tier 2, tier 3 means cities, smaller town cities like Guwahati, Shillong, okay? So these places will have, you can say, expected package to be in that range. Whereas for tier 1 cities, okay, it will be more. That means it will be around 8 lakhs, depending upon the technical skills and the company also. So that also is very, very important. Okay, so this is basically the skills that I wanted to show you. Before you search an internship, you will be called for the interview also. It's not that you just apply the internship and I mean to say you will get through. They will take an interview. So in which area you want to do? If you say, let's say I want to go for machine learning, then there will be core areas, but they will ask certain basic questions from Python, certain knowledge, basic questions from AI. So how, if suppose you will not know the basic, how it works, they will not ask you very much in depth, because they know during internship, you may not be knowing everything. But at least the basics, if you know, that will be very, very helpful. Okay, so that I would suggest that now it's May, I would count. So May, June, 2 months, you give time for yourself. And once you are done with the lockdown, you return, okay, being upskilled, so that you are sure that whatever comes in my May, I will take it up and I will get through. Okay, so you have to do it. Okay, so this was the skills that I wanted to develop for you all, okay, for applying for internship. Why? Because you will be asked. Now, apart from the skill base, like the areas that you are applying, apart from the questions from those areas, there are certain other things also that will be there interviews or the exams which is being conducted for internships, for induction of internships and campus recruitment or placements. Okay, so far, any doubt? Any doubt so far? Okay. Okay, so next I'll be speaking about how we are going to prepare. Okay, how we are going to prepare. Skills you have to develop on your own through various medium. It is up to you, okay, like these skills. But when you are going for placement, let's say recruitment process, or let's say if you are going for internship induction exams, okay, so what are the things you have to prepare? Okay, so if suppose we are calling some companies for induction of interns, or let's say you are going off campus also for applying for internships, most 95% companies nowadays conduct exams. And these induction exams basically comprises of many sections. Okay, so the first section that comes every time, whether you are going for internship, you can say prospect, or maybe for placement, the first thing is the written test. Okay, so in the written test, what are the things you should be focusing? So the first section that comes under written test is aptitude and reasoning. Now, this is very, very important. This is the first round every time. This is the first round every time. One should not ignore, because you cannot go to the second round until and unless you have not cleared this round. That is aptitude and reasoning round. Okay, so how we are going to prepare? So there are certain books that you should be buying. I should say buying, because this will be there with you for lifetime. And this book will not only be helpful for campus placement, recruitment or internship interviews, but also for competitive level exams as well. So what are the books? There are two books written by the same author, Quantitative Aptitude by R.S. Agarwal and Verbal and Nonverbal Reasoning by R.S. Agarwal again. Okay, so these are very, very important, like books, a must book. You should have it. There is no denial that you should not have. You have to buy. Price also is not very much, and I think you should get it. Apart from that, you can have one more book as a subsidiary. This is also a very, very powerful book, Quantum Cat by Sarvesh Kumar. It will help you in a lot, much more way. This contains exhaustive list of questions. Okay, so this also is very, very good. Okay, now see, when you go for such for appearing in written tests, it's not that, it's just 3 days or 4 days kind of affair. Okay, so what you need basically is you need a whole lot of practice. So you have to practice at least minimum 1 hour daily. Because aptitude reasoning is such a thing that if you are not in touch, you will forget. And you can be in touch only if you practice. There may be some shortcut techniques as well. So that will help you to speed up your target. You can attempt a more number of questions. And practice will give you better, you can say, confidence in attempting these questions with more clarity. So that will help you. So in that way, you should have these books. It's a must. From my side, 100%, you can take this that it is a Bible for every student. Okay. Then if suppose you want to go for, let's say, a website, which website will be helpful? It's not that this website, which I am stating, is a replacement for these books. This books is a must. But as a complimentary, you can visit this website, www.indiabigs.com. So this website will contain previous year's placement papers section-wise of different companies. Okay. So this is only for reference. However, for clearing in depth, practice along with those books is the only option for clearing the first round. And one thing I will tell you, how many places and drives that I have seen, 60 to 70% students are eliminated in aptitude and reasoning round. And most of the companies fix the target, the passing criteria at 50 to 60%. Some even 70% also. So 50 to 70%. So let's say if you are having 50 marks questions, let's say, in total, in aptitude and reasoning. So even if you are taking 60% of 50, so it'll come to 30 marks you have to get in minimum. So it's not very easy. And you will not be able to clear if you will not practice and you are not sincere with your work. Okay, so that is the first round. If suppose you have cleared the first round, then only you will move to the second round. Okay, now second round is a mixture. Second round, it's again subdivided into two parts. Some companies, they have only one phase, but most companies, they can have two phases in the second round. So the two phases are, one is the coding round, and the second one is the technical interview round. Okay. Second phase, since it's a subject wise and area wise, so since it is grouped under one point only, I did not segregate. So here you can have two sections. One is the coding round that will be, you have to code based on the situations and problems given to you that time. And second thing is, your interview, technical round interview. Again, some companies from the coding round may eliminate and take it to the technical round. However, some companies may take together coding round and technical interview round together and give a consolidated score. So it varies that from company to company. But what are the things that you need to prepare in order to clear the technical round? Okay, so first thing is that strong concepts of OOPs and data structures. These green ones are the most ones. That's why I highlighted with green. So your concepts in OOPs and data structures have to be very strong. You have to relate real-time problems with data structures. That means any situation or a problem that is given to you, okay, that time. So they may ask how this data structure will be applicable here. Can you write an algorithm? Can you translate the algorithm into a code? So that has to be very, very clear. So how it will be clear? Only if you are having good hold on OOPs and data structures. Then many people ask DBMS queries as well, again, based on the problems that will be defined by them. So accordingly, you should be able to be having a very strong grasp on this one. Okay. And then second thing, you need to know at least one programming language very nicely. They do not give, most of the companies do not directly say that you have to code here in this language only, but at least one of them, either C, C++, or Java, I would recommend. Okay, so knowing at least one of these languages very, very thoroughly will help you to clear the coding round. Okay, then these are basically you will be needing. Okay, all right. Okay, so now I think we can go. So here basically you will be needing to focus mostly on OOPS data structures. Then questions from data structures will be there. So I would recommend try to look for more applied based kind of questions on data structures. DBMS queries you look through. Then one programming language, you should have a very good hold on the syntax. Okay, main thing is the like most of the students, they come to us, oh, I know this language, but this language I couldn't do because I forgot the syntax. So you master one language, but the syntax you should be knowing because ultimately it is the grammar of that language. You have, should be knowing very, very nicely. Okay, apart from that, you should have a fair knowledge on operating systems and computer network. Some of the interviewers may also ask you to write an algorithm for a given situation. And also they may ask you to write certain code snippets, okay, to show your flow, program flow. So that is very important. Then these days, one more trend that I have seen is the database technologies also you should upgrade the learning. MongoDB, PostgreSQL, these are the ones which is very much used extensively among the database technologies. So you are learning in your, you can say, classes is very good. But apart from that, you should learn more, isn't it? You should be familiar with other technologies as well in database. So that also you should be able to refer online. Okay, so we have all the resources nowadays. So we should not say we cannot do it. We will be able to do it. Just that we need to use our smartphones, our laptops in a more judicious way. That is the only way. Okay. Now, you might be asking like how we will prepare, isn't it? It looks so vague. So see, these are the resources online will help you to prepare. For coding, you can refer to these open platforms. Okay, SPOG, TopCoder, LeetCode, InterviewBit. So these will be very, very effective for you for coding. I think I should zoom it. Isn't it? For basic computer science fundamentals, you can refer to Geeks for Geeks. I also refer, I've given you certain lectures also based on that, and I've shared you, so you can refer. You can enroll in various online courses. Okay, still you have time. Certain people may feel programming, I'll not be able to do it. Okay, but still you have time. You utilize this lockdown period very effectively. You can look through the courses at Udemy, Coursera, NPTEL, Swayam. These are very, very good. And if suppose you feel that you want something Indian and more concrete, okay, I follow Ravindra Babu Ravula from a long time. His lectures are very good. So among YouTube, you can go to this handle, Gate Lectures through Ravindra Babu Ravula. So he's very good, okay? So these are the resources that will be very helpful. Okay, and the way it is being structured, you follow. So first thing is you need to develop the skill. Okay, then second thing is because in interview, they will be asking, like suppose you want to go for machine learning. Okay, so they will ask you, do you have any knowledge? So if you can produce certain thing, if you know certain thing, you will be at an edge over the others. Okay, that is how, because everyone will think, why do I need to train someone or put effort so much compared to someone who doesn't know at all? Okay, so there always be a leveling, okay? Because everyone wants to look for someone who is skilled, upskilled. So that will basically reflect that you have the urge, the zeal to learn. So that's why it is very, very important that you have to be prepared. Okay. Now, if suppose you clear the technical round, so the last round is the HR round. Okay. So here you don't have any kind of technical questions to deal with. So basically, what you need to have is you need to have a little bit of decent English communication. Okay, because everything, the communication, when you start working, it has to be in English. English need not be very bombastic. English is something simple, decent, and something which can be understood by others. The main intention of any language is that it should be conveyed. The opposite person should understand. Okay, so it should not be very hi-fi. Simple, okay, and you try to minimize the grammatical errors, but simple. That means the opposite person should understand. I always say that to everyone. So what are the things you need to, what are the common questions that they might ask? So, I'll come to the question round. What are the areas that they might ask? So first is the obvious question. Tell me something about yourself or introduce yourself. The most of the mistakes that most of the common students make, like common students mean every student, 95% students they make, is that they talk about themselves. Now, about themselves, they have already, there in the CV, where you are born, okay? So that those things are there. So you need to highlight, you can speak maybe very briefly, but you need to highlight about your area of interest, you want to work, your skill sets, qualifications, or if any kind of achievement you have made in your career, okay, or maybe during the period of learning. Okay, so you should say, but you try to avoid saying things which is already there in your resume. And also when you answer to the HR, you have to make sure that it is not mugged up. That means you did not by heart those answers. It should look very natural, okay, so that they are happy, because ultimately HR people interview thousands of candidates, maybe if you are talking about the big companies. So they know, okay, the mindset. So you just be yourself, that is more important. What are your strengths and weaknesses? Okay, so be honest while answering the question. Okay, you should mention your strengths, but it should not be like 10-20 count of strengths you have mentioned. Keep it very simple, maybe 3-4. You should pick only the core strength that you have, and also the skill set that you have that will help you to contribute in the job. Okay, while you are talking about the weaknesses, you should be speaking the weakness in such a way such that it will ultimately seem that it is a strength only. Like for example, someone might say that I become panic if the work is not done within the deadline and I try to put more effort to complete the work. So what that has shown, okay, panic you have mentioned, it's a weakness, it's a negative quality. But whenever panicking situation arises, chaotic situation arises, then to control that one, you work hard. So ultimately, it's that weakness is shown as a strength. You have mentioned the word panic, but you're very intelligent enough also to transform that into your strength. And even if you have mentioned only the weakness, I get panic. So another question that is very much obvious, they will ask you how you are going to handle that weakness. Okay, so that also you have to be mentally prepared how you are going to answer. Okay, then another question they may ask you as a company or as a boss, why I should hire you. That also should be very convincing. Okay, so that will be basically be dependent upon your skill, your passion, your urge to learn new things, your contribution for the growth of the company or the organization that you will work on. These are the things that you can speak. Okay, then some may be asking you, are you a team worker person or an individual person? So you should always be a person who should be open to work in teams. Okay, then there will be obvious questions that there will be deadlines. How will you manage the work pressure? So those things also you should be able to be present to them. Okay, then another question, why do you want to join us? Okay, so before that, how you will reply, you have to do a little bit of survey about the company, about what they are doing. Okay, what are the achievements? Okay, what is the work-life balance? Okay, so there will be feedbacks You can check in Glassdoor. Glassdoor is very, very good. So I'm writing it down here. So from Glassdoor, you can get an overview of the people working there or the ones who have already worked there. There will be negative reviews as well, but try to look for the maximum. Like, let's say, for example, out of 100, you have 80 positive reviews and 20 negative reviews. So that means on an average, it's a good organization. The work culture is good. Okay, the behavior is good with the employees. Okay, it's much more on the positive side, because no organization will be very 100%, I mean to say, the best. Okay, so that is not possible. What is your salary expectation? That is the most important part. Okay, so this is a very tricky question. If you are fresher, never ever quote the exact amount that you want on your offer letter. Okay, so this you have to keep in your mind. You may ask him or her about the hike that the company generally offers to the employees, or maybe as per the company's standard, what is the you can say the package that they are shelling it out as a fresher. Okay, even in fresher also, based on the skills, do they have a slab? In general, you can ask, but quoting the exact amount, that can be, you can say, very, very detrimental in terms of getting the job. So that you should be very cautious little bit. Then another question that may come up is that, are you working with rotational shifts? So this is a very commonly asked questions in interviews of most of the IT companies, especially for the giants like TCS, Cognizant, Wipro, Infosys, and others. Okay, so answering a yes will basically help you in getting the offer. Okay, but generally, if you really want the offer, you should say yes. Okay, obviously we know. Now, time period of preparation for these internships and placements interviews, isn't it? The entire work, okay? So for internship, because everyone has to get internship. So that's why it's more difficult than placement, because someone may not want job. Someone may go for higher studies. Someone may become an entrepreneur. Someone may want to go for research. Their aspirations may be different. But internship is something that everyone has to get, isn't it? So if you want to get an internship, very nice, in a very good organization, and not only nice, but even in a like average level of organization, then the preparation should start at least 6 months before the schedule. So when is the schedule? We have the January. So the preparation has to start. That means everything. Preparation here means everything. The skills, all those skills that I have spoken about, then the core technical subjects that you should know, aptitude, everything. Okay, you should be able to start your preparation at least 6 minutes before the schedule of the internship period. That is very critical. Okay, otherwise you will not get. Then another thing, you may get, I'm not saying you will not get, but whatever you are intending for, you will not get. Okay, time or period of preparation of campus placements, at least 3 months before placement season. So last year we started having placements from October. So that means you have to start your work from July onwards. Okay, so placements and internship are almost parallel, the preparation. So you have to start your work in that way. Okay, some of the companies, they have group discussion also these days. Okay, so that I will maybe speak completely in a different class. Okay, how to tackle group discussion, what is it? If suppose a topic is not known, how we are going to handle it. Okay, so those things I'll do first myself, a little bit of study, a little bit of research, because it's very important that whatever we are conveying, it has to be appropriate. The content has to be appropriate and it should not be misleading. So hence I feel that any thing which is related to these kind of discussions has to be done a little bit of research. Okay, so that's all that I wanted to speak today for internships and placements. Okay, it's not basically expert. Okay, like machine learning, if you are targeting machine learning, you cannot be an expert in machine learning, isn't it? You are trying for internship in machine learning, but it is always advisable that you should be knowing at least the basics of machine learning. And that is the reason I had circulated some courses also about Udemy and Coursera, isn't it, in class as well as through the various links. So you do that and upgrade yourself. Some of them, MC, I think Suraj was telling me that he wants to go for Android learning. So do that, do it now only. Because once the classes sessions will start, it'll be very tough for you to manage the timing. Even if you manage, it'll be very tough. So that will be challenging. Okay, so please put up the question. Any question you are feeling, you feel free to ask. You can ask through unmuting your voice also, but only one person will ask at a time, or maybe you can type. So MCA, MSc Computer Science, and BCA, because this is very important. We have to clear all the confusions here. Yes, we do have written test, not like when they came last time, they had taken in written test, and other places also, if they are going to company, written test they had taken. So that's why it becomes much more difficult. So that's why you have to prepare in written test two sections. One is the aptitude and reasoning part. So until and unless you don't clear that one, you will not be able to go into the next round. And next round will be the technical round, and which are the subjects I had already listed out. Any other questions? This is an open discussion because it's very important that we have to know. Okay, otherwise if July the college reopens exam, then August then class is full swing, then how will you be able to manage the internships and placements? So that's why you clear it out now only. Yeah, I'll be sending you. It's nothing as a language, but queries you have to be very thorough. PLSQL is there. I think you will be learning that, you can learn. Okay. Then SQL queries, you have to be very thorough. PLSQL. Then some more advanced concepts are there in Oracle as well, like cursors, triggers. Okay. So those things you can learn. Okay. Okay. All right, you can MySQL, definitely it is one of the most liked database technologies, but you have to upgrade. Last time I remember one company had come, they preferred that the database technology to be used was MongoDB, and the program that they wanted to implement was in Python. So I mean to say, the choices are very different compared to, based on different companies, but you can learn as of now MongoDB. Okay, and second thing, MySQL, you know, Oracle also you can look through. These are the prime database technologies that people would be more focused on. Okay, if you want in Guwahati, there are certain companies, you have to approach them. So they also took interviews and coding tests. Okay, Libersoft was one of them. Then some more were there. Okay, since it's a recorded conversation, I would not like to name. But there were some of them which took interviews. So there are many of them. So what I will do, I will give you a list of companies that you can do internship in Guwahati. Even in IIT Guwahati also, you must be knowing that our students are doing. But apart from IIT Guwahati, other IITs also you can try, like IIT Kharagpur and all. Okay, so that you can do. Even in IIT Guwahati, they took an interview, if you know. For the MCAs, I think MCAs would be knowing that. Okay, So for IIT Guwahati, they had taken interview, and this time they are going to be more strict, they said. So that's why without preparation, getting internship in IITs will be very difficult. And if you want to do an IIT Kharagpur, then you can look for, but IIT Kharagpur are basically dealing with machine learning and data science. Okay, certain centers are there, so there you can look through. NIC, National Informatics Center, I think for BCA they are not giving, but MCA and MSc Computer Science can apply there, and BTech generally. Okay, so these are the areas that one can look for. Okay, so that we have to look. Yes, NIC is very good. National Informatics Center is a very reputed, like one of the most reputed government organization, which basically deals with information technology. So it's definitely very good. It depends. Actually, like in IIT, some of them, they are working in the CCC department. Then Computer Communication Center, yes, Computer Communication Center. So they are using technologies, Java frameworks such as Struts 2, I think, and some students are working on Hibernate. So it depends, actually. It depends upon the nature of work, okay? But definitely, yes, if you're working in an MNC or a reputed IT company, the exposure is more, and you have more feasibility compared to your job prospects also, because already the rapport will be established. So that will be more preferred. But again, IIT also has a different tag. We cannot just compare, isn't it? They are two different, I mean to say, different kind of organizations. So we cannot really compare, okay? But I think IIT also will carry Vishal was typing from MSc Computer Science. Anything, Vishal? Okay, that is so nice of you. Oh, you have the book already. That's so nice. Okay. Okay, Vishal. Oh, Vishal has which book? Okay, yeah, this also will do, not an issue. But R.S. Agarwal is the best of all. Any other questions? I hope the session was fruitful and you got idea also. Was the session fruitful? I guess it was fruitful. And second thing, this video, Arbaz will be making it very soon and it will be circulated. So Arbaz, one thing, you can circulate the links in three different places. One in the BCA official WhatsApp group, then one here. That link you can send in the placement committee also today, okay? Because MSc Computer Science and MCA also they will be needing. And one, you can give it to me personally, okay? So that will do. Yes, why not? No, for internship you will not be able to, but for job you can definitely apply. Okay, so that is very good. I mean to say, digital marketing is very, very nice nowadays. So for job you can do it. I think those who are very good with, I mean, just who like to speak English, okay, who are a little bit good with the words and things. So you people can try even digital marketing to learn. There is nothing harm in learning new things. You can do freelancing also. So some marketing ex, so you can work as a digital marketing personal as well. So you can think as a very well. Okay, so you learn this one. Go to Udemy, Udemy, and then you can pick up the digital learning courses from there. It's not that expensive also. So you can look through and you can get it done. Some more questions are coming. Okay, so good. The Google Garage is there. So students, look through. It's a free digital marketing course. So say special thanks to Aniket because he enlightened us. So good. Thank you, Aniket, from my side as well. The rest also can do that. And all of you switch to Google Garage and you can do it sometime soon, okay? So I think that's it for today. And sometime soon, maybe next week, I will be doing a session on group discussion, how to tackle group discussions. Then if I get certain links for aptitude and reasoning online, I mean to say in YouTube, then that also I will be speaking. So with that, I wrap up the session. So okay, so thank you for giving your time.